today. What was that? Could this be love? You're the kind of lover I will not get over.
Try.
Now you can rent all new releases or anything else for 5 days.
Really?
Yeah, so you can just enjoy it at your own pace. At other video stores, you only get 1 day on new releases. So you can't enjoy it because you're too worried about getting it back on time. And then you gotta fly out the door in order to get to the video store before it closes. And then the kids are screaming, "We want ice cream!" And you say, "Well, there's no time." And they say, "Well, you don't love us anymore!" And the clock is ticking and the phone is ringing and the late fees are piling up so high!
He's really into special effects.
5 day rentals on everything at Hollywood Video.
Follows a group of sexually ambiguous Gen Xers on an honest exploration of Los Angeles's ultra-hip underground polka scene.
Polka?
Every movie should have naked people.
Hey!
Rent on Braveheart or Bright Lights Big Titty. Those are two of my best.
I will shoot a scene in my ass if I feel like it.
You have to pay actors above scale for that.
No, Ray. I don't pay for sex. I pay for them to leave when I'm done.
I'm not gay, but you are the kind of guy, the kind of Calvin Klein, kind of sishi-mishi that would just turn me over!
I did 2 scenes on Saturday.
No.
Yeah.
No, we had sex on Saturday.
Yeah, just like me and Ron Jeremy.
Oh my God!
More bread, sir?
Well, what's that? Bravo.
The glamorous world of modeling. It's exciting and full of opportunities.
The parts that you audition for, besides strippers, are hookers, sex-crazed nurses, naked aliens.
If you want to succeed, you'll need poise. Charm.
I'm not going out there, you can see my...
And maybe a good surgeon. There are only a few supermodels. There are lots of posers.
Take your shoes off, please.
Next.
And behind every cover girl is a cover story.
I'm gonna get my own fat injected into my lips because it lasts longer and it looks really good.
Is that a big Barbie? No, is that Baywatch Barbie? Malibu Barbie? How about Airhead Barbie?
Their skin is flawless. Their lives are a wreck.
I have an aftertaste of your performance.
And it's sour. Sour.
Sour!
Every woman out there wishes they were us.
That is ridiculous. I've never heard anything so stupid.
Cassidy. Simone.
How? You pin the garment, not me.
Jessalyn, Ariel, and Tatya.
36D.
Are those real?
Does it matter?
Fashionably LA.
Hey, lady, you a model?
Yeah, I guess I am.
After a few years on the Parisian runways and getting overexposed in American magazines, unless you got a lucrative makeup contract, aren't you like washed up by the time you're 25?
Try to promise better. Try to give you my word, like my word is good. Try to think about you. Oh, trying to think's what I have to do. Baby, you know what you.
I just want to have a good time.
You know what you have to spend.
I love you.
Dude, what's wrong, man? Are you okay?
I need to know exactly how you feel.
God, you are so gross.
What the hell is this, Jack? I thought you had to go to work.
Jealous, abusive asshole.
Let me help you figure out your feelings.
How would you feel?
I'm gonna go crazy.
Dude, you should seriously consider seeing a psychiatrist, man.
Why is it that the only women who tell me they love me are these total psychos?
Jack, I love you.
And then the ones I need to hear it from wouldn't tell me if I tortured it out.
Wait, you didn't tell me what you think.
Chicks, man.
Really, 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 really more than anything else in the whole world, want to be.
Happy.
Me too. Yeah, how many girlfriends do you have that you haven't wanted to have sex with?
There's definitely one woman that I do not want to have sex with.
Okay, who's that?
My mom.
Hello, I'm David Folk, the director of The Road to Flin Flon. They asked me to say a few words about my movie, so, hello. Now, I know what you're thinking. He's a sock. But let me tell you something. Socks have feelings, and socks have minds. And yes, socks make movies, and I made this one. It all began shortly after my beloved mate disappeared without a trace, and that horrible laundry incident. I don't want to talk about it. Anyway, I needed a boost. Plus, I was very angry because there's a terrible prejudice in Hollywood against hosiery. If you're not under 25, gorgeous, and have arms and legs, forget it. So I decided to strike out on my own and make a film that would speak for all the underappreciated undergarments of the world. It's also for people who are searching for their own inner sock. And who isn't, really? So, sit back, enjoy, get some popcorn, have a few laughs. Bye now. Gotta run.
What the hell you need a camera for?
Well, I just like to tape all of my agent auditions.
Well, keep it off of me. I can't stand to be filmed. I get crazy.
No, it's no problem. It's just going to be on me the whole time.
So what are you going to play?
Well,
I thought I'd play something I just wrote, see what you think.
Go ahead.
Take you out and you talk real sweet.
Yeah. Yo, Jumbo Jim, what's the good word, Banks? Yeah, why, are you kidding? Get out, he's out of his fucking skull. $10,000, you're crazy.
Excuse me.
Yeah, no way, $10,000.
Excuse me.
Hold on, Jimmy, just a minute.
Do you want to hear my song?
No, that's all right. Thanks for coming in. So, Jimmy.
You weren't even listening.
You want my honest opinion, kid? You're too white bread for this business. Forget rock. Get into country, cowboys, western, or repair computers. Have a nice one. You still there, Jimmy? Yeah, another singer. What am I going to do? They keep coming at me. Anyway, tell him we don't touch it front to 20. 25 the most. Otherwise, I don't... What the hell are you doing, you son of a bitch? Get out of here, goddammit. I told you I don't want cameras.
You're always looking for the next best thing. You can't seem to settle down. You're always looking for the next best thing. Will you ever stop running around? Will you ever stop running around? P-I-N-G-O, P-I-N-G-O, and Bingo was his name. Oh, McDonald had a fun. P-I-N-G-O.
Ew, stink!
Let's go! E-I-I-O, E-I-I-O, muggity-biggity maggots. E-I-I-O, E-I-I-O, muggity-biggity maggots. Mama la papa la mama la papa la lily lolly lily lolly mama la papa la mama la papa la lily lolly lily lolly cal lily cal. How's that?
Good. You ready?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, we're rolling.
Here we go. Hello. My name.
Wait a sec.
The Road to Flin Flon, scene one, take one. Marker.
And action.
Shouldn't I say action?
Whatever.
Hello. My name is Joe Casco. Behind me, the city of Los... sorry. Keep it rolling. Hello. My name is Joe Casco. Behind me, the city of Los Angeles, California. I came to this city some 7 years ago. Like so many others, a young man with a dream. I dreamed I would turn my musical talent into a brilliant career with lucrative recording contracts, world tours, admiring fans in every corner of the globe. Well, sir, that did not take place. Instead, the dream drowned in a veritable sea of ignorance and indifference that cascaded forth from this Gomorrah, known with no little irony as the City of Angels. But believe it or not, there is a positive side to this story, because even as my dream has died, my spirit has awakened. And I can now see this city for what it truly is. A greed-driven, glitz-besotted, moron-worshipping visitation of hell on earth. And so, now a new chapter begins. Today, I'll be moving out of my apartment, quitting my job, saying adios to my girlfriend. And then, starting tomorrow morning at 6 a.m., accompanied only by my trusty cameraman, Arnie, I will leave this sorry burg and embark on a journey of self-actualization. The film you're about to see is my chronicle of that journey, a living diary, if you will, as I leave behind the spiritual decrepitude of L.A. and once again join the world of the real. And the hope is that if even one of you out there, especially you young folks, sees this and realizes that you are better off staying in Dubuque or Boise or wherever, then I think we will have accomplished something meaningful here, don't you? My physical destination is Flin Flon, Manitoba, where I plan to join the Avatuk Institute for the Advancement of the Inuit Peoples. Hey, get the hell out of here! What the hell are you doing, huh? You hump? You just wasted 200 feet of my film, thank you very much. Yeah, same to you, pal. God. All All right, well, keep it rolling. Let's just, we'll start again.
I'm almost out of film.
Well, go ahead and reload.
I forgot my case of film stock.
What? Arnie?
Sorry.
Jesus, I knew we should have done this on video.
Don't get pissed off, Joe. It's my film, too.
Yeah, but it's my story. I mean, when you screw up, I'm the one who looks bad.
Well, can't we just come back up here later?
There's no time to... All right, look, we'll do it fast, okay? Here we go. Keep it rolling. Hello, my name is Joe Casco.
Roll out.
At times like these, psychologists tell us it's important to achieve closure of the old chapters before we start into the new. And so, the first part of our journey is about closure. I've said goodbye to all my friends, which was no problem, really, since LA friends aren't real friends, like, say, Chicago friends. I've also sold off all the material goods that I've accumulated since moving here, keeping just a few bare essentials for the long trip north. We'll be traveling in this, my trusty 71 Benz, affectionately known as Roxy. Yeah, it's a Mercedes, I know what you're thinking, but this is LA, image is everything, babe. This is the building that I've lived in for the past 7 years. The old Casco homestead. Not much to see now, really, but in its flower, I guess you could say it was livable. Many days of agony and nights of debauchery within these walls. This is a living room. Note the cool flick of a switch fireplace for those romantic interludes. Over here we have the kitchen. What can I say? It's a kitchen. Down here is the hall. Hello, hall. The all-important bathroom. This is a closet over here. Oh, you know, it was said that Artie Johnson once lived in this apartment before he became a big star. I don't brag on that or anything. This is the bedroom where all the magic happened. Yeah, you know, one of the fascinating aspects of my life is that the light bulb in this lamp is the self-same light bulb that was here when I first moved in. I mean, it's never had to be replaced. It's truly a miracle bulb, really. Watch out for that big spider, Arnie.
Oh!
Just kidding.
Oh, man.
Hello?
Ah! That would be my landlord, Mr. Yi. Hi, Mr. Yi.
Hello.
You brought my security deposit, I presume?
Yeah. What's this?
Nothing. Just ignore it.
You shooting film here?
Mr. Yi, there seems to be a problem here. This check is only for $400.
Yeah, $400. And why are you shooting film?
I believe my security deposit was $600.
No, $400.
No, $600.
You sample carpet?
Excuse me?
You sample carpet?
No, I did not shampoo the carpet.
I deduct from deposit is in the lease. You look.
$200 to shampoo the fucking carpet?
You look at least.
Jesus!
You have permits to shoot film here?
Okay, look, I'll tell you what. I will arrange to have the carpet shampooed, and then you can give me the...
You cannot shoot film here.
I'm not shooting a film here. It's just a little personal documentary, that's all.
This camera?
Yes, it's a camera.
The filming camera?
Of course there's film in the camera.
You shoot film here?
I know, shoot film here. Shooting a film here would be like Paramount outside with 40 trucks.
It's my building, not your building. You need my permission.
This is utter Looney Tunes.
I give you permission. Costs $400.
What? No, no.
Remember, turn off gas and power.
No, wait. You hold on a second there, pal. You owe me $600. Not $400, not $550, $600 U.S. dollars now.
I no owe you squat.
Okay. Give me the check.
No.
Give me the check.
No.
Give me the goddamn check, you mutant ninja!
Eat a pinky, white boy!
Ooh. Ow! Oh, damn. Just another example of the filthy mammon that dominates life here in La La Land. Fortunately, I won't be needing that $600, because in Flin Flon, they care about people, not about money. Oh, look, there's a blue buzzard. Played a gig there once. Owner stiffed me $100. This is the store I've worked at for 3 years. It's a boring job, frankly, but at least I could say I was working in the business. Yeah. Everything a music aficionado could want. We got sheet music, amplifiers, drums, electronics, my personal favorite, the keyboard. And our famous Waldo guitars. Oh, that's my coworker, Margie, right there. Hi, Margie. Oh, see the guy in the back on the right? That's Tommy Madigan. He's my boss. I'm gonna give him my notice in just a minute.
Hi.
Hello. This is, I don't know, a customer.
Samantha.
Right. Oh, quick, look, the guy from Cheap Trick. Look. I just missed him. Oh, look. Left over from Woodstock.
Joe, you're late, late, late.
I'm sorry, Tommy.
I'm gonna have to spank those gorgeous volleyballs of yours.
But, this is Tommy.
And who are you now? Steven Spielberg?
No, we're just making a little documentary.
And you are?
Arnie.
Oh, hi, Arnie. Did anyone ever tell you there's a camera growing out of your eye?
This is Glenn.
Hello.
He's Tommy's friend.
Oh, go ahead and say it. He's my lover.
Whatever.
Oh, so prissy.
Look, Tommy, I have to talk to you.
Oh, Joey, I wrote this new song. You gotta hear it. Well, seriously. This is gonna make your socks roll up and down. Is this brilliant or what, Glenn?
Brilliant.
You know what? I was thinking you could play this with your band.
Tommy, my band broke up 6 months ago.
Okay, so Arnie?
Up in the morning, 10:30, cup of black coffee, my best friend. Up too late again, don't ask why.
Tommy!
Ow! Why are you yelling at me?
I'm sorry. I hate to be a killjoy, but it's just, I'm leaving.
Jojo, there's no way. You just got here.
No. I mean really leaving, like adios LA leaving.
You're leaving?
Yeah.
When?
Tomorrow. I'm sorry about the short notice.
But, you know, what about your band and
oh, all no, that's gone and forgotten.
Yeah, but what about the deal you had with what's-her-name and all
now
that?
No, it fell through, you know. I'm moving to Canada now, and I'm going to do a little social work with the Inuit people.
You lying piece of shit. You almost there,
man? No, I'm dead serious, Tommy. I'm dead serious. I'm all LA'd out.
You're serious?
Yeah. So, you know, I just wanted to say thanks for everything and, you know, good luck and all that.
I don't know what to say. I'm stunned. I mean, Glenn, are you stunned?
Stunned.
Stunned? I mean, I wish you would have told me or something.
Oh,
I could have given you a going away party or something.
No,
really, because I feel like I should do something
it's
for you.
It's not necessary.
You know, I'm going to write you a song for Joey.
Tommy, yes, really,
no,
you don't have to.
I insist.
Oh.
No. Arnie, hit. Okay, here we go.
This is a song about Joe Casco. Heart of gold and balls of brassco.
Tommy, some say he was a pain in the arsco.
Yes,
but to us he was just Joe. Goodbye, goodbye, Joey. Au revoir, farewell. It's been grand, it's been nice, it's been kind of swell. Goodbye, goodbye, Joey. Au revoir, farewell. It's been grand, it's been nice. Come on, Margie, come on, sing. The swell, when you're stripping blubber with the Eskimos, don't forget your friends down here and
please don't freeze your toes.
Oh, good, good. Goodbye, goodbye, Joey. Arnie, you too.
Au revoir, farewell. It's been grand, it's been nice, it's been kind of swell.
Come on, honey, come on, come on.
Goodbye, Joey. Au revoir, farewell. It's been grand, it's been nice, it's been kind of swell. Goodbye, goodbye, Joey. Au revoir, farewell. It's been grand, it's been nice, it's been kind of swell. Oh, goodbye, goodbye, Joey.
Any lingering doubts that I've made the right decision are now history. This is going to be the hardest part of my closure process. It's called breaking up with your girlfriend. Actually, we've been kind of rocky for a while now, so it probably won't be a big surprise to her, but she is kind of crazy about me, so this might not be pretty. Well, here goes nada. It's me, Bex.
Joey, how come you're not at work?
Well, that's kind of what I want to talk to you about.
Just a second. Hi.
Hi.
Oh, shit. Hi, Arnie.
Hi. What's with the camera?
Well, we're kind of making a little documentary here. Just pretend like it's not here.
Oh, okay. I'll just slap a little bit more grease in my hair, and then I'll get completely naked.
Come on, Becky. Work with me here, huh?
All right. But I'm getting dressed first.
Fine. Becky's house. Becky's couch. Some unbelievable sex on this couch.
I've heard that.
Hey, Joe.
Hmm?
We need to talk about distribution.
We already did. It's a documentary for the educational market.
Well, I really think we should go for theatrical.
Oh, Arnie, not that Hollywood shit again.
Well, with the right elements, this could be really commercial. We could make our money back. Besides, I need the exposure. That's kind of why I wanted to do it in the first place.
Let's not talk about it now, okay?
Shit. Oh, you putz.
I'm sorry, I just...
What's up, Joey? I gotta be somewhere.
Well, I just, I need to talk to you.
Want some weed?
No, thanks.
Oh, come on, Joey. I'm already halfway there. Don't make me have to go it alone.
Sit down, okay? I need you to look at me. Becky. This is very hard for me to say. See, why are you laughing?
Because you have this really serious expression on your face. And you have a big hairy booger in your nose.
Oh. Well, thank you for noticing. Cut.
Okay. Sorry. You were saying?
I was saying that we've been together for 2 years now.
No, I won't marry you.
That's not what it is.
Oh, that's too bad, because I really wanted to shoot you down.
Becky, I need you to be serious. This is important.
Okay. Becky is very, very serious. Okay, here we go.
Damn it, I'm trying to tell you that it is over, okay? We are finished. Tomorrow I move to Manitoba. That's Canada, you know. We'll probably never see each other again. I mean, do you comprende? This is goodbye, Becky.
You're serious?
Yes. Fine, you know, deal with it in your own way, because I gotta go. Becky's a very strange girl. Her emotions are sometimes kind of skewed from reality. Tomorrow she'll probably be bawling her eyes out, and it's sad, really, but, la vie continue, as the French say. Arnie! Last step before hitting the road to Flin Flon, saying goodbye to my Aunt Reba and Uncle Dave. My mom and dad live in Florida and New Jersey, respectively. Reba and Dave have been kind of like my surrogate parents here in LA. I guess I'm gonna miss them. Again, Arnie. Dave and Reba's house.
Or I should say casa. Come.
Hello? Reba?
Joey?
Hi.
Joey, what a nice surprise.
Oh. Oh, I hope it's not a bad time.
Oh, there's no bad time for you. You know that. Brad, Joey's here. Hi, I don't think I know you.
Arnie Panetti.
Yeah, we're doing a little cinema verite kind of thing here. I hope you don't mind.
Well, I'm sure it's okay. It's just the house is kind of a mess.
Oh, I love your outfit.
Oh, thank you. Did you know today is Tongan Independence Day?
I did not know that.
Mapa heptu mai iki. That means, oh, shoot, I forgot. bottoms up. Well, something like that.
Hey, Chris.
Hi, Brad.
How are they hanging, pal?
Bradley, really?
Uh-oh, candy camera.
Arnie, this is Brad. Brad, Arnie.
Hi.
Is this my screen test?
No.
Are you talking to me? Huh? Are you talking to me? Well, I'm the only one here.
That's what's his name from that awful movie.
Hey, see, I'm talented.
Yeah.
I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. Demir.
Brad, do me a favor. Brad, don't interact with the camera, okay?
Why?
Well, it just spoils the whole reality of it. Just pretend like he's not even here.
Oh, okay, Joe. And while we're at it, let's not think about pink elephants either, okay?
Oh, Bradley, don't be a poo-poo head. Can you boys stay for a while? Dave will be home soon.
Sure. Will you cut it out?
Oh, my goodness, why?
Well, yeah, thanks. I've been out here for 7 years. I haven't made it. I figure it's time to, move on.
Man's gotta do what a man's gotta do, Mom.
It just seems so sudden.
Where are you moving to, sport?
Flin Flon, Manitoba.
Bradley, really?
Where the hell is Flin Flon, Manitoba?
About 80 miles west of Snow Lake.
Oh, that Flin Flon, Manitoba.
Why there, for heaven's sakes?
Well, it's about as far away from L.A. as you can get where they still speak English.
Golly gushkins.
Actually, it's a really nice town. I mean, I read some brochures.
Are you moving there too, Arnie?
No, I'm flying back when we're done shooting.
You know what? I like this. This is one bitchin' idea.
Bradley, would you please not use that language?
No, I mean, this is the type of thing that people talk about doing. They fantasize about it. But how many people actually go through with it? Now, that's what takes cojones.
Yeah, so anyway, I'm leaving tomorrow morning, and I just wanted to, come by and say goodbye.
Joey.
It's a really bitchin' idea.
By the way, would it be okay if I stay the night? My lease ran out.
Good.
Okay, so they're a little strange. In L.A., though, this is what passes for mainstream.
What is that, Mom? It's a pineapple thing, huh?
I know. I'm not sure what they made, but it's like a pineapple.
Where did
you
get all this
stuff?
It's from the
caterer. A most excellent repast, my island queen.
Mapa heptu maiki, oh great one.
And now, a Tongan toast to Joey Casco. May the outriggers of your life always glide over smooth seas. Mapa heptu maiki.
Mapa heptu maiki.
Here, here, icky wicky.
Well, it was quite a surprise, Joe. You know, L.A.'s not going to be the same without you.
No, I don't think L.A.'s going to miss me in the least.
Well,
man's got to do the work he's called to do, Dad.
Well, that's a very interesting sentiment. Coming from someone who's never done a day's work in his life.
Oh, boy, here we go.
Maybe if we wait for another 20 or 30 years, you'll get your calling.
It's a tight market, okay? It's not my fault nobody will hire me.
Let me give you a little inside tip here, son. When you don't have a degree and you don't have any experience, you don't apply for corporate CEO positions.
What's wrong with that? I aim high in life.
I can see leaving L.A., Joey, but why the Eskimos?
Inuit.
Right.
Well, it's just something real to do, I mean, in L.A., it's so easy to lose your soul and all the
crazy games and the hype and the money chase. I want to get away from all that, you know, get in touch with my essential Joe-ness.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, Joe. I bet you come back. They always come back to L.A.
I don't think so, Uncle Dave, not me.
Arnie, put that camera down and eat something.
Yes.
How long you known Joe?
A couple years.
He's a talented guy, huh?
Oh, yeah. I think he's all wet about distribution, though.
Why?
Hey, he just wants to sell the film to schools and shit. I think we should go commercial all the way.
Oh, man. Oh.
Oh, shit.
So I kept asking her when we were going to sign papers. She kept putting me off. It turns out she didn't even care about my talent. All she wanted was a boy toy.
No kid.
Yeah, stuff like that happened all the time.
Well, Joe, I can't say that I blame you for wanting to leave, but... I mean, how many people, after all, really hit their bullseye in life?
What about you, Uncle Dave? Did you hit your bullseye?
Eh, yes and no. I mean, look around. Who could complain? I make a shitload of money. I got a wonderful wife and kid, even if he is a lazy bum. But on the other hand, I'm a proctologist.
Yeah.
I look up rectums for 8 hours a day, and then I come home and we celebrate Tongan Independence Day or whatever. It's the sum total of the adventure in our lives. Well, you know what they say. There's one thing you're really good at, and there's one thing that you really love to do. And if God is smiling on you, they're the same thing.
Pop 9000, huh? And they're all Eskimos?
No, just a few. That just happens to be where the Institute is.
This is too cool. I can't get over this. I'm getting a chubby just thinking about this.
Oh, well, thank you for your support.
You know what? I'm going with you.
What?
I'm going, Joey. It's decided.
Isn't this a little rash?
Of course it is. That's the beauty of it.
Brad.
Two cousins on the road. Taking it day by day. Living for the moment? Now that's what I call an adventure.
I don't know. I think you ought to think about this some more.
What for?
Well, it's not you, Brad. I mean, what would Dave and Reba say?
Are you kidding? They'd be thrilled to get me out of the house.
Oh, Jesus.
Sorry.
Brad, this is Flin Flon we're talking about, okay? There are no beaches in Flin Flon, okay? There's no spagos in Flin Flon. The girls don't wear bikinis. The weather basically sucks.
Let's put it this way. If I don't go with you, I gotta work for my dad this summer. Now, which would you choose?
What is wrong with working for your dad?
Excuse me. Do you remember what my father does for a living? I see enough assholes every day as it is.
Yes. I don't think so, Brad.
I'll pay for the gas. I mean,
all of it?
This gonna be hoot central, cuz. $2 gauchos on a rock and roll railroad, just like Damon and Pythias. Butch and Sundance. Who else?
Captain and Tennille?
Exactly.
Did you get all that?
Yeah.
Good, I might need it as evidence.
Joey, I got your mom on the phone.
Excuse me? It's gonna be cool, Arne.
I know. It took us by surprise, too. Well, he seems to be set on it. He's right here, sis. I'll put him on. Bye, dear.
Hi, Mom. Yeah, tomorrow morning. I was gonna call you when I got there. Of course they have telephones. Because I thought you would try to talk me out of it. See what I mean? Mom, I'm moving. I'm not committing suicide. Look, let me call you when I get there, please. No, don't put her on. Because she'll just ask me the same questions that you... Mom, please do not put... Hi, Grandma. Yeah, tomorrow morning. I was gonna call you when I got there. Of course they have phones. Because I thought that you would try to talk me... I'm not yelling. No, okay, I will. I promise. I love you too. Okay, goodbye. And so on this final night in Los Angeles, we pause to ponder the past and the future. That sucks. Keep it rolling. Silence. Serenity. Solitude. Night in LA is a time of many deceptions. That's even worse. Fuck it. Cut. Let's just get some sleep. When you get there, Brad, have you thought about that?
Same thing you'll be doing.
Yeah, what if you don't like it?
Then I'll do something else. Hey, you know what? We should sing a song.
I don't think so.
You start a trip, you sing a song, Joe. It's tradition.
Brad.
Let's see. Oh, 99 bottles of beer on the wall.
Oh,
99 bottles of beer.
No, you are not singing that song.
If one of those bottles should happen to fall, 98 bottles of beer on the wall. Sing, Joe. 98 bottles of beer on
that
the wall.
That song is illegal in the state of California. Are you aware of that?
If one of those bottles should happen to fall, 97 bottles of beer on the wall. Oh, you know what? When you guys cut the movie, you should put the words at the bottom with, you know, one of those little bouncing balls.
I'm not doing that.
Why not?
I hate that song, number one. And number two, there's no budget for special effects.
97 bottles
Will
of beer on the wall. 97 bottles of beer. If one of
Arnie,
those bottles that happened to fall.
Arnie, you're not filming this, are you?
I thought the idea was to shoot anything interesting.
Interesting, yes, not stupid.
Seems interesting to me.
Come on, cut.
95 bottles of beer on the wall.
Cut.
95 bottles of beer on the wall.
Devouring, life-sucking hellhole!
Not too pissed off, are you, Joe?
Yeah, well, you would be too if they did to you what they did to me.
What'd they do?
You know that song, that new song by Wayne Savage, Walk Away?
No, but let's say I did.
Well, it's mine. He stole it.
No.
Yeah, I sent his manager a tape over a year ago, right? He never responded. So then last week, I hear it on the radio. That was the last straw.
No shit? Yeah. The exact song?
Close enough.
Ugly. Oh, look. There's, Hervé Villechaize.
Brad.
It is. Arnie, look there.
That is not Hervé Villechaize.
How do you know? You didn't even look.
Hervé Villechaize is dead.
Get out of here.
You only thought that was Hervé Villechaize because he was a midget. To you, all midgets are Hervé Villechaize.
No, it really looked like him.
Yeah.
Where are we going?
You'll see.
What's here?
Wayne Savage's manager.
What? You're not planning anything, like, intense, are you?
No, I just want to rag on him some, shake him up a bit. You know, let him know there's a price to be paid for fucking with Joe Casco.
Why don't you just sue him?
Oh, yeah, right, like I can afford that. Here, put these on.
What for?
You're my tough guy, okay? I'll do all the talking, and you just look mean. What goes around, comes around.
Hasta la vista, baby.
You wanna play, huh? You wanna play? Well, say hello to my little friend, your basic kid.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
No, thanks.
I'm sorry, you can't bring a camera in here. Excuse me. Shit.
Hey, guys, what's going on?
Hey, where's Ray Singleton?
Who?
Cut the games, honey. Just tell me where his office is.
What are you talking about?
Yo, Ray!
Hey, this is a private session.
You Singleton?
No, get the fuck out of here.
You guys need to punish
Jang. Maybe later.
Joe?
Hey, Ray, come out wherever you are. All right, where is he?
Oh.
Joe, are you sure this is the right address?
Yeah, I'm sure. Pretty sure.
Come on in, guys.
Yeah, we give group rates.
Hey! What the fuck are you guys doing?
Never mind.
Now that was commercial.
Damn it, I know that was the right address.
So Singleton must have found a new line of work, huh?
Yeah, same thing, really.
Ow! What was that for?
Some tough guy you are.
Oh, shit, Joe. Did you see the size of that guy?
Yeah.
He was a gorilla.
Yeah. Son of a bitch must have moved. Well, to hell with him. I mean, I didn't want to stoop to his level anyway.
That is so cool, the way you can hang out the window like that.
Brad, please do not talk to the camera.
I'm not. I'm talking to Arnie.
Thank you for helping our film to suck.
You talk to the camera, why can't I?
I am the narrator, okay? Just act normal. If that concept has any meaning for you. I saw that.
Where we going?
Oh, I was thinking Canada.
Yeah, but why this way?
This goes to the 14.
No. Cut through the hills. You'll save 20 minutes.
I don't know that way.
I do. I've taken it a dozen times. Hey, take the next exit.
Are you sure?
Aye, Captain. Don't you worry now. I can navigate this baby just like a homing pigeon.
You know, I hate to pop your bubble, but Scotty was not the navigator. He was the engineer.
Well, who's the navigator?
Spock.
Ah.
Well, in that case, Captain, we will take the most logical route.
Wait a minute. Spock was the first officer.
Well, then who was the navigator?
Sulu?
I know. Chekhov.
Da, you're right, Captain. I will navigate for you.
Oh, I got one for you. Uhura.
I can't do Uhura.
Why not?
I'm only a B cup.
You know, I never realized it was so complicated.
Yeah, no wonder they caught it lost in space.
Did you say the next exit?
Yep. Oh, that reminds me of the one I saw yesterday.
So Picard has this amnesia, right? And Data and Riker are trying to figure out a way to get his memory back.
Are you sure this is the right road?
Absolutely. Take a left up here, on the left. So meanwhile, they're flying through this huge anomaly.
But we're we're hanging off the edge of the Earth here. This can't be a real road.
Joe, it's a real road. I take this road every day. It's a fine road. It's
got
a few bumps.
All right, fine.
It's
okay.
A road.
All right.
And at this point, Worf doesn't realize it's a Romulan spy actually on the ship.
This can't be right.
No, really. It was just on.
I mean the road.
Trust me, Joey, one more mile and we're there. So anyway, Riker, Data, Picard...
Homing pigeon. Yeah. More like a lobotomized goose.
What is going on here?
Oh, shit! Look at this!
You didn't put gas in the car? You set out on a 2,000-mile road trip with no gas?
I forgot, all right?
And he calls me a lobotomized goose. Me.
I can't believe you forget a thing like this.
Oh, hey, Homer, if it hadn't been for you getting us lost, we wouldn't be in this situation.
Oh, that's a very useful attitude, Joseph. Very nice.
Where are you going?
Back to the highway. Where do you think?
That's like 5 miles.
Have you got a better plan? Yeah. Sorry, honey.
Well, that's okay. This'll be good in the movie.
Yeah.
Hey! Excuse me! Dad, where are you going? Hey!
Ah! Arrêtez vous, cowboys.
Holy shit.
Why are you following us?
No, nothing. We're not. Our car's out of gas. Right over there.
Yeah, right.
I swear to God.
Who are you?
Arnie, don't shoot.
What are you guys doing, making snuff films out here?
No, nothing like that. Our car is out of gas. I'm not lying to you.
Show us the gauge.
Fine. No problem.
Allez.
Oh, perfect. Now we're being robbed?
Family loves to shoot. Put your hands up.
God, I love this city.
No, it's okay. Guess you are out of gas. Sorry about that. I just had a couple of wankers had us on last week, so...
Couple of what?
Couple of gits, you know. Je m'appelle Sasha. This is Taylor.
I'm Joe.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Arnie.
Hey.
Hi.
The lime mean a frog. Who would've known?
I know I'm not French. I just like the language. So how'd you guys run out of gas?
Yeah.
You don't want to know.
We thought maybe you guys would know the quickest way back to civilization.
Well... My car's parked a couple miles up just over that hill. I guess we'd give you a lift, if you want.
Cool. Thanks.
Beautiful.
Okay.
Praise Jesus.
Hey, cut it out.
Too fast, you lemons?
Oh, no. Don't fly. Hey.
Fine.
Well, let us know if you want us to slow down.
Oh, no problem.
Okay.
You know, many people outside L.A. don't realize that you can be in an apparently remote area like this and still be within the city limits. It's just another one of the sneaky ploys the city has of sucking people in. Sorry. Rest assured, though, right over these hills is the blight, rot, and urban decay that we know so well. What was that?
Nothing.
Okay.
So, what do you guys do?
Well, I'm a social worker.
Oh, yeah? South Central?
No, North Northern, actually. Flin, Flon, Canada. We're on our way there now.
Really? I thought you were a filmmaker.
Oh, really? What gave you that idea?
A wild hunt?
No. This is just a one-shot deal.
Efu, Brad?
Moi?
Freelance chief executive officer.
What companies?
You know, you wouldn't know them. Lockheed, Apple Computer, TRW.
So how come you're going to Canada?
Just checking out the climate. You know, business line. You gotta keep a tab on these things.
Well, you never guess what Arnie does. Tell him, Arn.
I'm a cinematographer.
Good to Lord.
You don't think they're hot?
Brad, we are leaving town.
You know, if we can get them to take their clothes off, I guarantee we get this movie sold to the Playboy Channel.
That is not why we're doing this.
kind of like that tailor. You want Sasha?
I don't think so.
Why not? Well, call me old-fashioned, but I just have a problem with women who pack heat.
Okay, so the other way around.
God, why are they going so fast? You know, thinking they were just on a little hike in the hills, the two travelers suddenly realized that they had unwittingly entered the Ironman triathlon. Oh, shit! Are you okay?
Oh, man.
Yeah. Oh, is the camera okay?
Yeah, I think it's all right.
Hey! Can we stop a few minutes? Hey, ladies! Ladies, can you stop with the king?
The ferris conveyance, parched of its vaporous lifeblood, they set across the vasty desert, Sullen Joe and Ernest Brad, led only by naked trust of their distaff allies.
Formidable.
Are you a poet?
Yeah. Well, a journalist, actually.
She wants to be a poetic news anchor.
Yeah. Uh-huh. You know, the way they tell the news is so boring nowadays. I just think it should be dynamic and full of feeling, you know, just like the events themselves. So I do it with poetry.
Makes sense to me.
Yeah. Searing, scorching, with avenging fury, the flames ascend. Blackened walls silhouetted against the blinding orange miasma. That sort of thing.
Is there a big market for a poetic newscaster?
No, not now. Way for the future, though.
Oh.
Here, come on.
Sure.
Right, I'm off to the loo.
Are you a journalist too, Sasha?
Oh, no, I'm an actress. And a part-time gynecological model.
Oh. Huh?
You know, for medical films and whatnot.
Are you especially well qualified for that? I'm just asking.
It's not a bad job, actually. Flexible hours, good pay.
I would think it'd be, I don't know, kind of embarrassing.
Pourquoi? Nobody sees your face.
I'm not able to conceptualize this. You think maybe you could give, like, a demonstration or not. You know, either way is fine. Thank God. Yes.
And so closes another chapter of Iditarods I Have Known. So, you girls ever been to Flin Flon?
No. You ever had splenectomy?
No, but I'm hoping to.
You two should come with us. It's gonna be mega hoots.
For Bob.
I hear there's a shortage of poetic newscasters and gynecological models up there.
We have lives here in LA.
Yeah, if you call this living. Oh, wait for Arnie.
Wait for you here, okay?
Okay.
I'm hitting a can.
All right.
Oh, Brad.
Huh?
Oh.
What the hell is this?
It's one.
Yeah, right.
That's a 20.
Yeah, I need gas. Just go to the bathroom.
Go!
So? The agony or the ecstasy?
I don't know. I haven't made up my mind yet.
Yeah, me neither.
I think Joe kind of likes you.
And I think Brad kind of likes you.
Convenient, huh?
You know, that camera guy's kind of cute.
Oh, oui, je crois.
Yeah, but he doesn't say much, though, does he?
I think he's married to his machine.
Yeah.
Hey! Oh. Did I miss anything?
No, did we?
If you only knew.
How long are you standing there?
Just now.
Hey man, can you play that in A?
All right.
Hey! Hey!
Hey, man! Hey!
Come. Look me in the eye, man, huh? Can you look me in the eye? You can't do it, can you? Son of a bitch! What the hell was that?
Nothing. Let's go.
Nothing?
Yeah. He was a bass player in my band. He took off with all our equipment. It's... forget about it. It's ancient history. Listen, we really appreciate this.
It's fine, no problem.
You sure you guys don't want to come with us? We could keep you warm in those cold Canadian nights.
Allure. Next life, maybe.
Well, good luck.
Thanks.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Oh, shit! What in friggin' hell?
Oh, my God. They ripped the battery off.
I don't believe it. I do not believe it.
Son of a bitch.
Was this here before?
Oh, Jesus, my car.
Doik?
What the hell is a doik?
It's probably the guy's name or something.
God damn it. I mean, this is the only city in the world where you can park your car out in the middle of fucking nowhere and some asshole named Doik will steal your battery.
What a bite in the waz.
Man. Listen. Would you mind?
Come on.
Thanks. With any luck, we'll make it to Flin, Flon by the millennium.
Well, wait a second. Shouldn't somebody stay here? Pourquoi? You know, watch the car. In case Doik comes back.
It's a good point.
Yeah, we could come back and it'd be totally strict.
Thanks for the thought, Brad.
Okay, okay. So, who?
I'll stay.
Don't you need him along to shoot the film?
Fuck the film. I mean, this part's not going to be in the film anyway. You can stay, Arnie.
I gotta have the gun, though. Go ahead, Johnny. Make your move.
Doik show up?
No. You get it?
Yeah. $75 worth.
I chipped in 5.
Yeah, and don't think I didn't appreciate it. Hey, Arnie, on this next bit, can we do like a speed up thing?
Sure. Cool. Yeah.
So anyway. Well, I guess we'll be pushing off then.
Listen, we really appreciate this again.
We're going to my brother's in Encino. He's having a little party de piscine.
A party to piss in? What did you say?
I know, a pool party. If you guys want to come by.
Yeah, right now?
Mm-hmm. No, thanks. We gotta get going.
He's a big music promoter.
Really?
Yeah, Joe. You should play him your stuff.
Yeah, Joe. Stuff.
You know, that part of my life is over, but thanks anyway.
Whatever. If you change your mind, it's right on the corner of McClure and White Oak.
Okay.
It's you.
Same to you.
Bye.
Bye.
So long, Ernie.
Bye. Don't even start with me.
Five minutes.
No.
Five minutes. Joe, they're free food. Joe, they got enchiladas. They got taquitos.
Yes, insidious forces are clearly at work here now.
Come on, Joe.
There seems to be a conscious effort on the part
anyway.
Of Los Angeles to suck me
we'll
back in.
Just a couple more hours.
Everything that's happened today is just...
They want our bodies, cuz.
Do you mind I am narrating here?
How can you pass this up? Joe, the guy's a music promoter.
So what? I'm a social worker.
What could you possibly lose by trying?
Do you want to know what happened if we go to this party? I'll tell you what'll happen. Everybody will talk me into playing some of my music, which I will do. And this guy will say, that's great stuff, man. Why don't you give me a call on Monday? So I'll get my hopes up. And I'll call him on Monday. Only on Monday, he won't take my call. In fact, I will never hear from this guy again. That, my friend, is L.A. in a nutshell.
Fine. Now you expect nothing. So you can't be disappointed. Am I right, Artie?
Don't ask me. I just work here.
Look, are you committed to Flin Flon? Because if you're not, man, I
exactly
can
exactly my point. This could be our last chance to get laid for months. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, Marty! Hey!
I say you can never be Toro's own.
Huh?
It's a joke, Mark.
Oh.
Yeah.
20 minutes? All right. Are you gonna bring what's her name?
You know.
What's her name? No, that was her sister. Wasn't that her sister? Huh?
Yeah, that's her. When?
Yes.
But who was navigating? Do you remember?
You know, I think it was Uhura.
Uhura?
Yeah.
Yes.
I always thought it was Spock.
Welcome to my particular favorite of the L.A. institutions, the Hollywood Party. Invented, I believe, by Swifty Red Eagle in the year 1612. The key to defeating the seductions of a gathering like this is to make sure that you do not, under any circumstances, derive any enjoyment from it. Arnie!
Sorry.
And the Vulcan mind melt. I can do that, you know.
Oh, really?
Yes.
What?
My mind?
Yes.
Okay, think of something.
Okay.
Oh, three more.
Woo! The whoosh is great. You should come in.
No, actually, we can't stay very long. I want to make it to Vegas by tonight.
Oh, come on. Don't be a dry guy.
No, really. We gotta go.
But I want to see you wet.
Well, I would, but, you know, I have this chlorine sensitivity. It's not very pretty.
You wouldn't lie to me.
Me? No, no. If I were lying, you would know it, because my left eyelid would flap like a window shade. Hey! Easy! We got a camera here, man!
Ciao.
See ya. Son of a bitch.
You're not gonna believe who lives next door.
Who?
Lauren Tweez. You know, from the Love Boat? Julie, the cruise director? I'm not shitting you. You can see her right over that fence.
Thank you for keeping me abreast.
Maybe I should get some shots of her, Joe.
What for?
Well, in case we decide to go theatrical. It's easier to sell a movie with stars in it.
I believe you have taken one too many fastballs to the temple, my friend.
So, Jim, how's it going?
It's Joe.
Right. Sasha tells me that you're a musician.
Well, I used to be, but I have other pursuits now.
Oh, he's talented as shit, though. You ought to hear some of his stuff, Martin.
Really? What kind of stuff you do?
Pop rock.
Ha! Right up my alley. Yeah, I'll give you a little listen later on.
Hey, Frankie! Put it back on! You look like a beach whale!
Keep my shorts, boy, I'll
Hey, you guys want to do some toad?
Pardon?
A little toad?
This is 10 times better than blow. The beauty of it is, it's 100% natural.
Ah.
Watch your step there, Alfie.
Arnie.
Right.
Listen, Marty, this isn't dangerous or anything, is it?
No. Not if you know what you're doing.
This is Mick, Bufo Alvarius. Say hi to the guys, Mick.
Hi. Marty, look, we really got to get going.
See this stuff right there? 100% pure USDA approved Bufo tenning. One hit of this and you're in cloud nine.
No
get
way.
Out of here.
Yeah, really. It's deadly to toad predators, but people just get this incredible jolt.
You're joking.
No.
So what do? Like scrape it up and put it on your plate? What do you
do? No, you just lick it right off there.
What? Mm-hmm. Oh, so you're telling me you're going to put your tongue directly onto this amphibian? That's disgusting.
You got it.
I'm...
Like this.
Oh, yes!
Oh, heaven.
Yeah, well, listen, that's great, Marty, but...
Who's next? Bob? Brad. Yeah, right. Come on, it's your turn, big guy.
Are you sure this is okay with the Toad Society of America?
Hey, come on, it'll put some more hair on your chest.
Yeah, and warts on my tongue.
You're not gonna do this, are you, Brad? Brad, oh, no, oh, Jesus, no, man, oh, my God, no! Ow!
Oh, it's so...
It's Mick. Hello, Mick.
Little toad.
Oh, my God. That is sublime.
Did I tell you?
Just, Joe, you got to try this.
No, I'm going to pass on that. No, thank you. No.
Come on, cuz you have to.
Look, I never lick toad while I'm driving. It's a personal thing.
Come on, man. It'll only last 10 minutes. Come on.
Come on, Joey. No lips. No lips.
All right. Okay. Look. Just in 15 minutes, we're out of here. Okay. That's our deal. All right.
You got it, tongue. What?
Okay. All right. Look. Let me just sort of sneak up from behind here. You would never see this in Des Moines.
Lick. Oh,
Come on here, you Russian ventures!
give me that. You almost dropped it.
Oh, okay.
Let me turn this thing off.
What you're observing is a classic case of bufo crash. Just another of the many consequences of drug abuse. Kids, don't let this happen to you. Shit, what am I doing? Brad, we gotta go, buddy. Come on. Come on.
Johnny, let's hear those songs of yours.
Oh, Marty, I would, but we're on
tight... No. Come on. You're among friends here.
Yeah, come on, Joe. What's the name?
Yeah, don't be shy,
come
Joe.
On.
All right, now, remember, I don't do this anymore, and still got a little toad in my throat, so.
Yada, yada, yada. Play! Come on!
I think I'll take a drive tonight. Hide out under the neon lights, ride in circles round and round, contemplate this crazy town. I was taught persistence pays, and true love wins in the end. I bought it all just yesterday. But this is now, and that was then. I'm slowly going nowhere fast, chasing after dreams. No matter how the story goes, it's never what it seems. And I've run out of reasons for living on a prayer. Find a road to somewhere, a road to somewhere. Gotta find a road to somewhere.
Yes. God, you really are good.
See what I mean? Talent.
Excuse me a minute.
He really liked it. Hey, I know my brother, and I'm telling you, he liked it.
Well, then why didn't he say anything?
Oh, he just does that sometimes.
Yeah, right.
Oh, come on, Joe. Don't be so negative.
Yeah, bud, you blew us away.
Yes.
You know what? It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, because I don't really care if he liked it or not. Because I'm not a musician anymore, okay? At least he didn't say to call him on Monday. I hate that.
Jerry, come out here a second. There's somebody I want you to meet.
Oh, all right, take it easy.
You know something, Sunshine? Yes, it is. But there's one thing I've learned in this business.
Jerry, I want you to meet a real good friend of mine. This is Ray Singleton.
How you doing, kid?
Hi.
Nice to know you. Oh, well, I... I guess I should have shaved a little closer this morning, huh?
Wait a minute. Ray Singleton, the manager, Ray Singleton?
Whoa.
I think your reputation precedes you, RG.
Hey, will you just cut the camera, please?
Does the name Joe Casco mean anything to you?
No, maybe if you hum a couple bars, I can pick it up.
You crack me up, Singleton.
Walk Away by Wayne Savage.
Mmm, great song.
Oh, wait. Hey, Savage is one of yours, isn't he, RG?
Abalula, yeah. Yeah, you're a very smart guy, Jer.
Joe. Listen, Ray.
You know, I was listening to you earlier on. You got something.
Thank you.
So tell me something. Who's representing you, John?
Joe. Nobody.
No. What a damn
listen,
what are we
going to
do?
Listen, Ray, I don't care what kind of hot shit manager you think you are. I don't take kindly to people ripping off my songs.
Ha ha!
Kid. You're gonna love this kid.
Almost had us here, Jimmy. Yeah,
come on, come on. You know, let's have a little powwow, all right? Roll camera.
Marriage made in heaven.
Ow. Hey, Chief, how'd it go?
Well, that was Ray Singleton.
Yeah?
So what'd he say, shall he?
Oh, Ray Singleton?
Ow, Brad!
Did you tell him where he could stuff it?
Not exactly. He wants to sign me as a new client.
Anyone for the beach?
Oh, boy.
I can't believe I'm actually considering this.
Hey, if I were in your shoes, I'd jump on this.
What about Flin Flon?
No rush. If it doesn't work out, we can go later.
No. No way. Plan A stands. 1 hour at the beach, and then we're out of here.
Hey, Joe. I'm gonna need to talk to you alone for a few minutes when we get there, okay?
Private beach all to myself. Don't I come here 5 or 6 times a year?
That's great.
His brow furrowed like a newly planted cornfield. The young man brooded. Darkness wrapped round him like a shroud.
No, I'm not brooding, Taylor. I'm contemplating.
Oh, come on, what's to contemplate? Just take the offer.
Well, it's not as cut and dried as that. I've had offers before, you know. They just never pan out. In fact, the better off it looks, the more likely it is I'm gonna get nailed. I don't wanna set myself up for that again.
Has anyone ever told you, Joe? You're an extraordinarily dark person.
I am not dark, I'm just realistic.
Joe, you make Darth Vader look like the Doublemint Twins.
No way, I'm a very spontaneous and fun guy, aren't I, Arnie?
Oh, he's a regular Tinkerbell.
You're dark, Joe.
I am not.
R2.
Am not.
Well, prove it.
Oh, that feels oddly stimulating.
Let's just put some on. Now, I am a fun guy. Oh, God. My entire life is hanging in the balance, and I'm sitting on the beach putting sand on my pants.
Doc.
What do you think about when you're, you know, working?
I don't know. Different things.
Do you ever get kind of...
What?
Well, you know, sort of...
No. No one did you.
It's an honest question.
It's a job, okay? That's all.
So do your boyfriends have a problem with it?
Frankly, Yeah.
Yeah. What?
I don't think that's such a swift idea.
What do you mean? It's very swift.
You're leaving town, remember?
Supposing I wasn't.
But you are.
Just supposing I wasn't.
Brad.
You do think I'm cute, right?
You don't have a job. That's numero un on my eliminator list.
Oh, now that's just flat discrimination. That would be like me saying to you, oh, I can't get involved with you because you have a wooden leg.
What?
Man, oh, man. I'm very disappointed in you, Sasha. Thanks.
Arnie, do you mind? This is a private conversation.
Not anymore.
Please turn it off and tell Joe I don't want this part in the film.
This is good, though. It's dramatic.
Give us a break, Arn, please.
Well, the good news is I'll be taking a little bit of L.A. with me to Flin Flon. The bad news is I'll be picking it out of my pubes until Christmas. Or something.
Oh. You're really hell-bent on this, aren't you?
It's the only way to leave L.A. I mean, if you try to do it half-assed, you never make it.
I just don't see why you're so bitter. I mean, there must have been some partly pleasant moments.
Of course there were. That's the way this town keeps you going. You know, they give you just enough encouragement, and everybody's so bloody nice, and everything around you is so goddamn pleasant that you're just completely unable to focus on how miserable you are.
You were following your dreams. I mean, doesn't that count for something?
Yeah, but you know what I realized the other day? Is that even if by some fluke I make it, it would be no good. Because I'd be stuck in a business full of assholes for the rest of my life, and I just can't handle that, Taylor. I gotta operate on a higher plane.
Excuse me, could you guys scooch in a little? I can't get the framing on this. A little more. A little more, please. Yeah, it was good. Woof.
You know, I once went 3 entire weeks without getting one single phone call returned. 3 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
I sent it into the Guinness people. Still waiting to hear back.
You know, Joe, there's bullshit in every business. That's just life. In L.A., Flin Flam, what's the difference?
Flin Flon.
Well, you just gotta focus on the good, and then you roll with the bad. Stick with your dreams, Jose. You're too young to be bitter.
And you're too young to be wise.
Oh. I was an acceleration program.
Oh, I see. I believe that. Why does there have to be a music business? Why can't there just be music?
There just was. Stick around, big boy. I'll make it worth your while.
Wait a sec. Okay.
Damn it! There it is again. You see what I mean?
what?
You let your guard down for 2 seconds.
What are you talking about?
Nice try, LA!
You are a very strange man. Do you know that?
I'm sorry, Taylor. Please don't take it personally. I mean, you're fantastic. It's just, you're obviously a pawn in a very evil cosmic plot.
Tell me about it.
I gotta go. You ready to hit the road, Arno?
Can we talk now?
Yeah, sure. Please, excuse us. So what's up?
Well...
Hey, Joe, we got a minute?
Well, I'm talking to Arnie right now.
No, that's okay. Go ahead.
Thanks. Little change of plans.
What?
Well, Sasha says she can get me a job with her brother, you know, helping him book the act, shit like that. So I think I'm gonna stick around LA for now. Now, normally I wouldn't take an assistant-type job like this, but the thing is, it gets my foot in the door to promoting. Besides, I got the ultra-hots for Sasha. I think she could be the one, buddy.
Yeah, well, fine. If you want to be led around by your dill rod, far be it for me to stand in your way.
Why are you pissed off?
Why am I pissed off? Because if it weren't for you, we'd be halfway to Flin Flon by now.
So now you're rid of me. You should be happy.
Yeah, well, maybe I got used to having you around. Did you ever consider that?
Gee, Joey, I didn't know you cared.
Yeah, well, I don't. All right, if you want to stay, stay. I don't give a flying fart burger.
You're a brick, cuz.
Yeah. Go on, get out of here. Go on. Come on. Get the fuck out. So what do you want?
Oh, it can wait.
Yeah. Yeah. Almost got me there. The city is very, very cunning. It'll try every trick in the book to keep you from getting out. Fortunately, I'm just a little bit smarter.
All right.
That was
is that everything?
That's it, Chief.
Yeah, next time don't bring your bowling ball, okay?
Hey, Joe, think fast!
Oh! Well, that's everything.
Hey.
Hey. See you again one of these years, huh?
Sure. Knock 'em dead, champ.
Bye, Joe.
Bye.
Don't freeze your buns off up there.
Okay. Well, if I do, I'll send you one.
Merci. Bye.
Au reservoir.
Bye.
His indignation roiling like an angry cloud. Battered, badgered, stung, but never bowed. Joe Casco took his leave, new bounties to retrieve. I'm gonna miss you, Joe.
You can always come with me.
Yeah.
Well, take care.
You change your mind.
It won't happen.
I know, but...
Okay.
You never know.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye.
We're off.
I think we better talk now.
Yeah, well, let's do it in the car. I gotta make a clean exit for once. See ya. An ending, a beginning.
So anyway, I guess I should have brought this up earlier, but I was waiting for a better time. Joe?
Sorry, what?
I was, well... There's really no gentle way to put this. The thing is, I can't go to Flin Flon with you. Marty told me he needs cameramen for a Pearl Jam video. I couldn't turn it down. I'm really sorry.
I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. You know, it's always a pleasure to have my worst nightmares brought to reality.
We've already got a lot of good footage.
I can't believe you're doing this to me. I mean, you of all people.
Joe.
I'm out in left field, but I thought we were friends.
We are. But hey, an opportunity like this?
Oh, my God. I mean, do you realize how much money we've already sunk into this?
You can have the film. It's yours. Come on, Joe. I wouldn't deny this to you.
It's a distribution, isn't it? All right, look, fine. We'll try for theatrical, I promise.
It's not that. Look, I know this other guy.
Oh, my God.
He's sort of new at it, but I bet he'd do it for you in a minute.
I am leaving Artie right now, today.
Oh, I think he would do it. I'll pay for him.
Oh. Oh, God. What the hell am I doing? Maybe I'm crazy. I mean, maybe it's not L.A. Maybe it's God. Maybe it's God, and he's trying to tell me to forget about Flin Flon and just stay here and live soullessly ever after. Will somebody please tell me what to do?
Really, I'm sorry, Joe.
What the hell is this?
Get out of the car, Holmes!
I don't believe this.
Let's go! Move it! You too, Fellini!
You got it.
I said, get out of the car!
Uno, dos.
Hey, what the fuck's the matter with you, huh?
You know what? I don't feel like getting carjacked just now.
What?
Well, if it's all the same to you, I'd just as soon take a rain check on this.
Joe?
You motherfucker! Get out of here!
Holy shit!
What's that sound I hear, man? I think that's your mama calling you!
You're crazy, man. You belong a fucking Camarillo.
Thank you. You too. Have a nice day.
Holy shit.
Get in.
My God, Joe.
Okay. That's it. That's all I needed to know. Thank you. Gun?
No, thanks.
Sayonara, Tinseltown.
What are you doing?
Just running out this roll.
Go to bed, Arnie.
I'm really sorry about Hairball. I didn't know you were allergic to cats. Well, good night, Joe.
Ow, jeez! Oh! Sure you need all this stuff?
If you want your film to look good.
Arnie doesn't use this much.
He's got his style. I've got mine.
Listen. What was it again?
Steve.
Steve. How old are you?
19.
19.
Say, what does this mean?
Doik. It's Urdu for don't ask. Excuse me, just one second. Arnie, are you sure this kid can handle this?
He'll be fine. Trust me.
Yeah, you I trust. Him.
Okie dokie, man. Ready to roll.
Ow! Oh!
Ooh.
Shit!
You okay?
Will you stop?
Is that blood? Let's see it. Come on, man. Move your hand. Sorry, Joe. Are we stopping here for a reason?
Okay, You gave me your best shots. And I took them. I think it's pretty obvious now that you can't beat me. But there's really no reason that we have to part enemies. As long as we both understand one basic thing. I win! And you lose! Woo! Goodbye, Ellie! Who's the RC Fartsy shit, huh, Steve?
Just trying to give it a little zip.
Yeah, well, please don't. Let's go. Over 100,000 people will leave Los Angeles this year. They each... Steve? On me when I'm talking, okay?
Ever heard of an establishing shot?
I'll say when to do that.
Okay. Garbage in, garbage out.
Okay. Let's try that one again. Over 100,000 people will leave the city of Los Angeles this year. They each have their own reasons, of course. Some have no choice, job transfers, family concerns, what have you. But most, like me, have made a conscious and deliberate decision to... What are you doing?
Dude driving that car?
What about him?
That's Danny Bonaducci, man!
Steve, let me explain something to you. We do not concern ourselves with Danny Bonaducci. What we are leaving is the grand embodiment of Danny Bonaducci, which is to say the city of Los Angeles. We are no longer in a Danny Bonaducci state of being. Can I make myself any clearer on this point?
I don't know, can you?
To continue. Where was I? Damn it. Cut! They leave because they've become profoundly aware of the spiritual void in their lives. They seek renewal. And yet, astoundingly, as many as half of the people who flee Los Angeles actually move back there within 3 years. I won't be drawn back to LA because, for me, the dream is dead. I think the city understands that now. That's why it stopped trying to keep me from going. It knows it's not as determined to keep me as I am to leave. Yeah. That's exactly why that is. It's definitely why that is. Sayonara, Tinseltown. Guess you're wondering what happened. Well, I fired Steve in Barstow and put him on a bus back to LA. No way was I gonna spend 5 days in a car with that guy. Anyway, when I finally got to Flin, Flon, I discovered that the Avatook Institute had been converted by the Inuit into a casino. I don't know what made me think they needed my help to improve their lot. Anyway, they were looking for a lounge act, and so I took the gig on a temporary basis and, you know, till I could get a new plan together, and, well, to make a long story short, I was a big hit. And so here I am, 3 months later, knocking them dead in Flin Flon. Yeah, I know, it's not the Hollywood Bowl. But there is something to be said for being a big fish in a small pond, too. I make a decent living, made a lot of new friends. That's my buddy Josiah Crank in the camera there. Say hi, Josiah. Do I miss L.A.? Well, I wouldn't be totally honest if I didn't say I do, sometimes. I don't know, maybe in a year or so I'll head back down there, give it another shot. Maybe give Taylor a jingle, see what she's up to. For now, though, this seems to be all the dream I need. As for the film, well, it didn't quite have the ending I was expecting, so I figured I would just junk it. Then I thought, what the hell, I mean, maybe adjusted dreams are just as meaningful in the cosmic scheme of things as abandoned ones. I don't know. What do you think? Now I found a road to somewhere.
Our very own Joe Pesto, ladies and gentlemen. Joe Pesto.